chat. How are we? Just figured I'd do something a bit different today. Gonna do some painting, listen to some tunes, chill out, have you guys in chat, jump in, have some conversation. Yeah, just see how things roll. So yeah, this is gonna be something I'll do as well. Jumping in, I'm working on some Space Marines at the moment, so I'll be cracking on with those guys and just have a bit of a chat. I hope you guys are all having a good Saturday. So yeah, howdy howdy. So I'm working on some company champions, actually. That's they're coming up pretty well. I've got some coats that need to go. Currently, as you can probably see, I'll probably bring it up a bit further for you. Hopefully that'll focus in. They've got the base coat down and, got gold and metal to go. So hopefully, and I do my stuff in sub-assemblies as well. So I'll just be kicking back, listening to some tunes, cracking through, and it'll be some good fun. If you're working on stuff this afternoon as well, post up with your Charon. I've been in this hobby for, a decent amount of time. If you want to hobby tips or you want to chat about specific things to do with Warhammer 40K, just post up in chat and happy to have that conversation. So I'm going to pick, I'm going to keep on going with some lead belcher on these guys. I think what I might do is just adjust the actual volume on my headphones so I can actually hear myself a bit better. it's pretty good. Love to hear what you guys have been working on recently as well. I might get the base coats done on these guys, and I might crack on to actually building some of the Indominus Marines as well at some point soon. But may get to that today. There we go. That's a bit better. So yeah, just getting the base coats down on this guy. Yeah. There's been a lot of leaks, a lot of rumors happening in terms of 40K. I'm not the biggest fan of, trying to talk about that kind of stuff, before it comes out. But, there's some good stuff for the Marines, I will say, that I've seen. But yeah, I just hope that they execute it correctly, because if they don't, oh, well, then power creep. It's always a thing. But yeah. and just working on putting some more work into the my second Space Marine Battle Company that I've got. I've had sitting there, but I'm just still getting to the magnetized guys. So as you'll probably see, up and in there, it's a magnet. I tend to do that with a lot of the weapons and different guns for different units, depending on, you know, what I want to run, obviously. At the moment, I'm actually running my Marines with Death Watch and, you know, running with Death Watch because I've got my own chapter and, you know, I like Death Watch as well. So that's how I'm playing them. It's good fun. But yeah. So it just reminds me of that small piece down there that I should probably do on him too. How are you guys in chat? What's been happening? You know, what have you been working on recently? Just, yeah. You know, everyone's at different stages with their hobby. I mean, for me, I've been in this gaming hobby for about 10 years. So, 10 to 12 years now. It's good fun. I've come to thoroughly enjoy most aspects of the game, I would say. But yeah. They're not my actual glasses, chat. They're just some blue light glasses because I tend to get headaches when I am video gaming for too long. And, you know, I also noticed it at work. It's a bit of a thing. So. Sitting in front of a computer too much. Concentrating on a screen that's emitting blue light. That's just my experience. Never used to. Yeah. That's how he's going. Being my first painting stream, of course, I'm gonna, you know, remember not to paint up here and paint down here where I'm used to and all that kind of stuff. So I might just move the camera forward a little bit in that case. are certain things that require a bit more effort and I take a bit more time with, but my basic Space Marine chapter is not one of them. Really, I just more focus on, you know, base coats, washes, and then edge highlight the armor. That's, yeah, and then that's what I consider done. You know. And they actually come out really nice. So yeah, that's hopefully what I'll end up getting these guys to. Probably not today. We'll see how we go in a couple of hours. I'll be only streaming for, you know, 2-3 hours, so. But yeah. Hope you guys are having a good day in chat. You know, if you've been working on any hobby or been playing any games recently, you know, feel free to share, have a chat. But yeah, just hanging out, doing some painting up some Space Marines. Just, you know, enjoying a nice rainy Saturday afternoon here in Canberra. Trying not to have my light skewing on camera either. It's a bit of a finicky thing, but he's there. But yeah. Oh man, the heater in here is killing me a little bit in terms of how quickly this paint is deciding to dry out. So, just whack that guy off. Hopefully it'll cool down a little bit in here, but not too cold. But yeah. Yeah, I've got a fair amount of Space Marines sitting there. My kind of project for this year has been working through my backlog. So I've been trying to smash through at least 2 units guys that I've had sitting there that I just actually just need to finish off some final details or washes or finish the basing on. I'm getting those guys done as well, so I think I've got the list that I have in my hobby journal is something like, I think, 36 units total. So if I do 3 a month, technically I can get it all done. And next year is virtually the exact same thing. So, but yeah. Now, I'd normally, when I'm painting, this is an insight to myself. I'm also a gamer, so if you guys are, you know, video gamers that have come from one of my previous streams to check out what I'm working on, or you know, a hobbyist as well, normally I'm someone who's actually checking out, I'm watching a lot of Escape from Tarkov streams, generally, as I do hobby. That's just me personally. You know. But yeah, it's just. How I roll, I suppose. Good old nice pair of lightning claws for this dude as well. So each veteran, it's got like a combi weapon of some kind that I'm painting up. One's got a combi melter, the other one's got a combi flamer. And then each have got a close combat weapon, so this guy is going to have the lightning claw, then another dude has got the power axe, and each one's got its own stats that are good situations that it's in, the situations it's good for, I should say. But yeah, now, by no means am I an amazing painter. I just paint my stuff up, get it done. I have it sitting on the shelf, not actually being painted or assembled or stuff like that. I'm sitting on a full set of Shadow Spear that I got towards the end of last year that I've only just built this year. I'm going to be working on next year, so there's that. As well as Indomitus that I will hopefully be able to get through. Plus whatever I don't get done this year. So, a lot of painting for the year. But, should be a good time. Just smash through it and, you know, just get it done over time. Yeah. If you're just joining us, my name is Scotty D49. ask at the moment?
Nothing in particular. Just two company veterans to go into an existing squad that I've got. I've had sit down. Been meaning to work on for a hot minute. But, yeah. Now I'm finally getting to them. Finally putting a lick of paint on them. So, yeah. Hang out. If you're working on hobby yourself, post it up in chat. Love to see some pics or even just a description of what you're working on. But yeah, just working on getting the base coats down on these two guys. Eventually, at some point in the future, I'll get some get a couple of mates on, and you know, we'll end up doing some actual games as streams, which would be nice. You know, whether it's highly competitive ITC style stuff or just more casual games, we'll see. So, a few things that I've done, you've probably noticed, not many other people would. Well, some people would, actually. So I tend to just airbrush my base coat for the blue first, before anything else. Gets the blue paint down, and, you know, I'm able to work from that and just do touch-ups later when I need to. Not have to worry about actually going in, doing every Marine like that. Because for the most part, you know, it'll end up streaky and you don't want that without it being clean. So yeah, that's what I start my process with. And generally I'll sit down for a day. Not sure if I'll end up doing it on stream. I've got to do one of those days, an airbrush day, coming up, and just, you know, smash out. I think I got a devastated squad that I've magnetized for my other two squads sitting there. I've got, yeah, a bunch of stuff. Jeez, there's a lot. There is an absolute lot of stuff. Yeah, Devastators I want to brush up. I've got a unit of 3 Primaris Intercessors from Dark Imperium still. I want to get done. I've had those for years now. It's ridiculous. I want to get those guys done. And then that's actually it for that box set for the Marine side. I've still got the Death Guard. But I'm thinking of doing them as Black Legion. The Nurgle is, you know, the Black Legion side of things, personally.
Yeah. No.
It's always the tricky thing with flamers and melters, is always those divots. weapon in particular that I'm working on right now is fine cast. So it's got a fair bunch of bubbles I haven't gone back through and fixed up and all that kind of stuff. So... better than it was when it first came out, I can tell you that much. Remember the first couple of models they released in fine cast, and oh my goodness, they were riddled with them. Absolutely horrendously, too. So. I was playing a bit of Tarkov earlier today with some other guys. It was good fun, but I didn't really stream it. Did record it, see if I can get any gameplay from it, but you know. You guys are having a good Saturday afternoon chat. Yes, the magazine is stuck in the blue tack to allow me to paint the rest of it. Still requires painting itself, so it's just particular parts. I'm getting it done. You guys working on anything in particular, chat? You know, anything on your hobby table, whether it's building, painting, basing? Post it up. Love to see it. Alright. dead as a doorknob. So. Fresh pot. I hate how these G-dub pots decide that they're just going to store paint along the bottom, around the rim. But then also around the top as well, which is how you get the clumps around the top of the rim, is that. I'm getting messages on Discord. From the guys I was playing Tarkov with earlier. But yeah. If I'm hearing that popping up, chat, you're hearing that popping up. So, that's my Discord. Starting to tell me things. But, yeah, it's what it is. Still haven't done a main color on the guns yet. I'll get to that probably this afternoon. I just want to get some of the smaller spot colors on. Just working on these Space Marines. You guys having a good day, chat? Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, wherever you are in the world. It's currently about 5:30 in the afternoon in Australia, at least on the east coast, which is fine. Yeah, I'll be on probably till about 7:00. Working on painting up these Marines. Now I'll put the second coat on this dude's face because he needs it. The first one was very streaky. You might be able to see that. Yeah, quite streaky in terms of the application. But that's what happens when you do two thin coats. The second coat's really there to cover that up. Get it on there. stuff that's been leaked for Marines, or whether it's Necron stuff as well. And what you're thinking that's going to do to the game. And the impacts of that. Personally, I think 2-wound Marines might be a bit of a little bit of a trap. Yeah, 100% see them finally getting it. But this song reminds me of Borderlands 2, the intro. It's just so cracked. So good. That's why I love the song. Time to get some red on these guns. Now, generally, the red will also take two coats in this instance, just so it gets a nice, solid, even coat as well. There's also other spots the red's needed too. So, just using corn red for this one. If you're wondering what colours I'm using, just ask me in chat. The blue base for my Marines is always a Cantor blue. I always love that, the darker blue. go back and do touch-ups anyway before I actually go into the next step, which is the washes. I'll always do a touch-up step. You're probably wondering what's red on this guy. Purity seal. Hit that guy with this red as well, including his eyes. So. Yeah, just paint away. What do you guys enjoy watching or listening to as you do your own hobby? Yeah. Smash through some stuff and just chill. For me, my paintings are very cathartic. I find it. It's my way of winding down at the end of the day. More often than not, I'll spend maybe half an hour to an hour painting before I go to bed overnight. Just to fully wind down and focus on something that isn't saturation or under saturation as well, that there's actually going to be paint on the brush. If there's more than you need, that's fine. You just carry it out. Hit more surface area than what you'd probably normally would. But even then, I know I'm going to need a second coat anyway, so it's not like massive. So slowly getting through it. If you've just joined us, welcome. I'm ScottyD49. Just working on some Space Marines for Warhammer 40,000. It's my primary choice of war game to play. But it's not the only thing I'll probably end up painting on stream at some point in the future. I also have got a huge, and I'm talking huge, collection of Lord of the Rings Middle-earth strategy battle game miniatures that I'll probably get to as well at some point, because I absolutely enjoy that game, but hardly any time to actually play it. It's a game I got into when I first started in this hobby. A good mate of mine introduced me to it, and I was just hooked. I loved Lord of the Rings growing up, you know, what the films and just the universe of it. And so yeah, I'll probably paint up. I primarily play dwarfs for it. I've got a massive dwarf army that I need to repaint and clean up and all this kind of stuff that I had sitting there for years. Painted it probably when I was about, what, maybe 15, 16? Smashing the thing out. At least what I wanted to use for tournaments. Right now, I want to go back, do a better job. They're already all stripped. But yeah. Hope you guys have a nice, relaxing Saturday afternoon chat. Saturday morning or evening. Wherever you're located in the world. If you join the content, feel free to throw a follow if you decide to. Completely up to you though. I'm just doing this whole streaming thing. share links to what you've been working on. So that, you know, if you want to share what you've been working on, love to see it. You know, we're all in this hobby together and we're all, you know, working on our own stuff. We have our own style. So, you know, the thing that I'm actually really looking forward to coming up is I've actually procured a second half of Indomitus for the Necrons. So, I've actually got both halves sitting there, and I'm going to smash that out next year at some point. Love to do, not necessarily a 24-hour painting challenge, but maybe something like a 12-hour, just, you know, during the summer holidays, whilst I'm not at work. Except stream, paint from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., take breaks, all that kind of stuff. Do something like that. I reckon that'd be fun. You know, if you've got any, you know, ideas of things you want to see on stream, feel free to let me know. I'm always open to suggestions and hearing stuff. Very similar thing to the red that I do with your Shapti Bone. I do it for all my purity seals or anything specific. I'll use this for it. And I always tend to water it down and do two coats. It's just easier. Even if I oversaturate it with water. what it should be. There, that's a bit better. God's also one of the ones, the Hashuk Copper, that I generally will do two coats of. Particularly on things like this piece on the shoulder pad. Yeah. Making some good progress on these guys. I'm really happy with how far I'm getting them this afternoon. Smashing out these base coats. Getting it done. Might do a bit of a different wash on that too, just to break it up a little bit. But I know that I do need to do a small spot of gold on that skull, on the axe. There's going to be another one on the other side. Because it's already metal. Okay. I'll end up doing another one at some point. Yeah. Hope you guys having a good day. Had a good arvo. See, there's that small gold axe, gold skull on the axe, I should say. That's actually like them done for the first round of base coats. Yeah. Of course, the guys being all magnetized, like you guys probably won't end up seeing the end result unless I, you know, do another stream at some point in the next week or two when I actually finish. Sit down to properly finish them off. But I'm just gonna go over and do a, you know, another code for a couple of things. Probably the red, and then the Ushapti bone as well. The gold on that shoulder pad. Maybe a second coat of the gold all across all of them, just to get it all covered off and looking good. But yeah. Oh man, there's been some funny memes recently, 40k related. So I'm just like, that's just hysterical. And it's 100% Australian too. Like, there's this one that I think Frontline Gaming shared this morning, and it was, I saw it when I woke up, and I'm like, that's that's classic Australian tournaments, just right there. Where it was like, you know, all the events before COVID, like, kind of thing. And it was just saying, oh, I miss tournaments. It's like, what do you miss most about events? And it was like, round one at 8 a.m. Like, really? And then it just shows a picture of, I think it's Will Ferrell, cracking open a beer. And the caption is, me at round one at 8 a.m. Like, you know. I've been at events like that, that they've, you know, guys have been cracking out beers at 9 a.m. in the morning. And I'm like, geez. Right. All right. Their choice. It's the way they enjoy their events, I suppose. I'm not of that persuasion, to be honest. But, you know, back when I was a serious competitive gamer, I was playing for the big stuff. I was going hard. I was there to, you know, not just have fun, but also to play well. I did that, but for some reason, top 10 was always my cusp, it was always my glass ceiling. Trying to get through that was hard, and then I was just burnt out from it. Really haven't looked back since stopped playing tournaments. Run at events really as well, do that as well, like on 40k tournaments. Good fun, can enjoy it, but when you just deal in the politics of it, it's draining. So I stopped, took a break, so now I'm back doing it and I'm enjoying it. Heck, I'm even working on a side project about it, so it's good fun. I should hopefully dry pretty quick, because I want to go back over and do that gold again, but I don't want to do it before I do the red, so I'll do the red now. I do need to clean my palette. As you can probably see, I use a tile, and so it's very easy to clean. I just use a old homie knife, and a scourer under hot water, and I just scrape as much off as I can with the hobby knife under the water. It's an old one, so I don't really care if it gets rusty. And then also just, then whatever's left after doing it that way, I use the scourer. Do that in my steel kitchen sink, because it's steel. All the ones upstairs in my place where I'm at right now are all porcelain, so very bad to do it on porcelain. Trust me, I've learned the hard way. You stain porcelain very quickly with dirty water, especially with water-based acrylic paints like these ones on it. Now you'll probably see that I'm probably wanting to do it more of a quick application of the red, just in all the same direction, so that it constantly hitting my head on my light with my headset. It's annoying. But, you know. I could swap over to, like, iPhone headphones, but I'm not a fan. I don't want to do that. I'd rather use a gaming headset, to be fair. To do this. But, yeah. No, hope you guys enjoying the stream. Just hanging out. Watching me paint some dudes. Done the red on this dude. On the weapon, I should say, for this guy. That red's done. It's always good every so often when you paint to stand up and stretch. I tend to do it every hour. It's what I like to do. But go for an hour 20 and haven't done it. So. Means you're not bending over the entire time or straining. gold won't just be a second coat, it'll also be some touch-ups. So. I always think it's better to do two coats on most golds or metals, just because then you're able to get a solid color out of it, especially if you've, you know, like in this case, you've got another color other than black underneath it. That way you're not getting that pushing through that kind of hue of that color influencing, you know, the shade or even how it's seen. Then you just come back and you touch up those parts underneath quite easily afterwards. Yeah. Okay, at the same time, I'll go do it and do this guy's the trim on the shoulder pad as well. Do the second coat. Yeah, you'll see, it's probably pretty hard to see, actually. I'm leaning it on the table a fair chunk, or at least resting my hand on it, on the table. Once that focuses in, it decides to. Should be able to see that. Yep, there we go. That's what it looks like with the second coat. Light probably doesn't help with that too much, but yeah. Hey, Rana, thanks for the follow, bud. Hope you're having a good one, man. Just hanging out, painting some Warhammer 40K today. Have you guys been having a good day? second coat and all the gold across all of them. Well, these two, I should say. Of all the different pieces, because they're in different parts. So. Sometimes this brush is pretty good at doing those touch-up areas like this guy. But of course, I'm probably going to need to go in with a finer detail brush to touch up that gold. But yeah. The only problem is this brush, you know, considering it's pretty new, but I'm going hard on it, is it's got this little curve at the top. It's handy in some situations. It's not so handy in others. If you want to get in that curved little tiny spot, it works nicely. But if you're not, then it can sometimes skew it. So I just have to try and use that to my advantage in a way. But, you know, it's only a base coat brush, like, it's not, you know, one of my finer detail brushes, or, you know, I've got better brushes that I use for this more detail work that I'll be getting to. But, yeah. What have you guys been up to on your Saturday? What's been happening? I know some of you guys might be tuning in that, you know, might necessarily know or know a little about what I'm doing, or, you know, just coming to watch and have a look, and that's fine. Yeah, welcome. But yeah, how's your weekend been? What you been doing? And my Discord's going off again. As expected. It's those same boys I was playing Tarkov with earlier today. Yeah, I probably won't get on again. Should probably get on before I actually head down for dinner tonight with the wife to reset my fuel and stuff like that. But for the most part, it's, you know, is what it is. and I'm sitting there, getting it all done on one piece and then move on to the next one. Find all the areas that I need to do touch-ups and just keep on going. But yeah, so it's getting there. Just working on the second coat of the brass on these guys right now. This should almost be done, this dude. Well, at least this part of this dude. I think I've still got the skull on the gun to go, and then he's fully, done a second layer of gold. Which I'll also do with the same brush. That way I don't have to... load up another brush, but also it's a bit tighter because it's a skull rather than a quiller like on the other dude. Getting it done. I'll probably have to take a photo of these guys at some point, post up on my local group's Facebook page. To show off the progress that I've been doing, what I've been working on, and the fact that it's just base coats. Because I tend to, being an admin of the page, I try to post stuff up and encourage the guys in getting their own hobby stuff done. All that kind of stuff, being here in Canberra, there's not too many, there's quite a number actually, I should be honest, in different hobby groups, but the one that I'm an admin for is, the largest one, which is nice. So being able to encourage the guys to be like, keep on going with what you're working on and, posting up pics and sharing what I'm doing. That's good, if you're wondering, how to just keep on pushing through with your painting, best thing I can suggest, small amounts. For me, I used to try and tackle 10 squads of 10 dudes at once, and oh my gosh. There would be times where I'd just be like, I'm so over this step. But this year, with my challenge, I've only been doing, I think the largest I've done has been a unit of 6. And that's a unit of scouts, Space Marine scouts. 6 dudes. For that. Which was fine. That actually wasn't too bad. And they were in a style that I'm happy to go and, replicate on my other scouts that I've got to go back and work on that are on the list, but then there's 18 of those compared to 6, and I'm doing them in a lot of 10 and a lot of 8 instead of doing them in 3 locks of 6, which I should probably do, to be honest. But yeah, if you guys, if you haven't already got a hobby journal, I 100% recommend it. I only just started doing one this year, but it's good to keep track of what you've done, where you're progressing, what you still want to get done, all that kind of stuff. Sorry, chat. I was just had a bit of a sneeze there. Wasn't particularly fun, and I didn't want to blow your your guys' ears out with a sneeze. So. Alright. I would call that base codes done now on these dudes, which is good. I'm happy to get that done. You know, it took me almost 2 hours. You know what? Progress is progress. Time to move some stuff aside so I can take a photo of these dudes. Now, the light may change for a sec if I do this, as I face it onto them. But I tend to put my camera underneath. Light is. You know what? I still haven't done that bolter. The mag on that bolt gun. I'm gonna post up saying I've done base codes. At least you can't see it, I suppose. Alright. What I might do is I might even pop that in on chat. So you can actually see what they look like. Actually, I'll send you, I'll post up the link to the post in the group. So, I probably won't be able to share it with you guys. However, there is another way I can share it. Just bear with me for a second. So, just gonna have to move this guy. So, once that thing autofocuses, that's, you know. That's those dudes. They're done. Well, at least for the base coating. Apart from the I'm just reaching over because on this desk, I've got this guy that's got the Indominus stuff in it. And I think we might put together Lieutenant. Now, I have done the Captain. I'll pull him out. That should be it, actually. One of those guys. And the instructions, because you always need the instructions. Never not use instructions, chap. They will save you some time. Hey, Reinarth. Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm good. How about yourself? What's been happening? Just been hanging out, doing some painting. Now I'm building some stuff, so... But yeah, been pretty well. Surviving everything that's been going on lately with COVID, because that's always a thing, right? How about you, dude? It's been a while since we've caught up with each other. What's been happening? Yeah, it certainly has. Actually, I'll probably flick you a message off stream. Yeah, right. Whereabouts you've been more, like, you know, south or down near Canberra, you've been, you know, north. Just, yeah. Whereabouts? Oh, sick! I was actually gonna... Yeah, awesome, dude. Not sure what time you'll have, but if you've got some, let me know. We'll see if we can catch up. Okay. Not sure how far away that is, to be honest, but... shouldn't be far, I suppose. Like, Canberra's, you know, in the middle of nowhere. That's probably within, like, an hour, 2 hours or something like that. To hear that you've been able to keep on working, you know. I was on stand down for about 6 weeks there. Yeah, for sure, man, for sure. We can definitely chat more off stream. But yeah. Nah, good to hear that you're going well, brother. Everything's going alright for you. I see you've been playing a bunch of different games as well. I think you were on Rocket League the other night. I'm just cranking that out. Yeah, nice, nice. sick, dude. I need to do that for my PC. I need to, you know, organize an upgrade for mine. The one I'm streaming on right now is the one I got for my 21st, and it's whatchamacallit. It's all right. Like, it's got two 960 Strix graphics cards in it, but you know, they do show their age a little bit. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. We'll see. I think this PC needs a bit of an upgrade, that's for sure. But it still runs really well for doing streams and stuff. I should probably bring this over a bit more so you can actually see. So I'm just working on the torso. Just cleaning it up, really. Mod lines are a thing. Oh gosh. Yes. That's sick. We can definitely chat more about that, brother. That's for sure. But yeah. Of course. Been something I've, you know, doing the stream and starting to, you know, do some of this stuff. It's been something I've been wanting to do for a while, actually, to be honest. It's just now that I've actually gotten some decent webcams. So I got the ones that is this guy right here that I'm running off. He's actually a Logitech C920. It's one of the highest rated ones for streaming. That's not like a SLR camera. So, yeah, definitely getting more into my PC gaming and PC gear, that's for sure. With Tarkov, you know, I think that's what finally did it for me. But yeah, so, got another about 20 odd minutes chat where I'll be here kicking around. Work on this lieutenant from Indomitus. So I've already done my captain from the set, and he's not glued together because I like sub-assemblies, but that's how I've done him, just with the bare head on the simpler base. You know, you can pull off the shield, so it's a bit easier to paint in. Ah, too easy, Reinhardt, all good. Yeah, shall do, man, shall do. So this guy's the captain from the Indominus set. Really cool model, I will say. It's a lot of parts that I'm not the biggest fan of, like that little shield on the front. Bit iffy on it, but you know, it is what it is. Everyone enjoys their own bit of flair, I guess. And you know, that's the flavor of the new intercessors that they have in the box with the assault intercessors, I'll say. Sometimes you just gotta get into a file. Knife. Sometimes you'll be able to do it, sometimes you won't. But I'm not gonna lie, I think I need to change this blade, so I'm gonna do that. Because, you know. You know, my local store was out of blades recently, and I went in and I was like, oh, I could use some new fresh blades, and they're like, oh, sorry, doing it. And they're fresh out, I'm like. But now that I've finally got some back in stock, I was able to get some fresh ones. I always keep another container that I keep old ones in. And then I'm able to, you know. So then they're all in the one spot and I can dispose of them relatively easily. Now, this lieutenant has got some funky kit, if I do say so. And I'm just stepping on my mic cord, of course. chat, let me know if it's not, please. But, yeah, I could probably check it as well. By just having a look at my Streamlabs. Yeah, it's still coming through fine. Perfect. So, now that there's a fresh blade on it, I've got to be really careful that I don't cut myself, because these things are freaking sharp. But, oh yeah, that's... able to clean that up. So yeah, just need a fresh blade. You guys in chat managed to get your hands on a kit of Indominus, if that's what you were hoping to get. I tell you what though, I was lucky. I was very lucky to get one. 'Cause it was, I rocked up at my local game store at, I think it was quarter to eight in the morning, and, quarter to nine, and I was second. By the time the store opened, it was like, we had maybe... line at 30 to 40. Actually, it was more like 30, 35, I should say. I'm going to change this song. There we go. That's a better one. Now, I'm used to having this so close to my body that it's actually out of camera shot. So, I'm going to pull this a bit further over. I'm going to pull myself in. So then, I got no excuse. You're going to see exactly what I'm working on. Now, considering this is my first stream, like, you know, I'm still getting used to doing this kind of stuff. So... yeah. gaming away on Tarkov, or it's me doing hobby stuff.
Heck, I might even get some Warzone going.
But, yeah. We'll see.
Depends on what you guys enjoy. Now, this is a problem. Push fit models.
spot this guy has to go in, and it's like right like that. Now this guy's probably a bit easier because I can probably glue him together. But I don't want to. I'm not going to. Alright, and then this guy has another pauldron. cool. That's, I think I'm going to call that there, chat. It's been good hanging out with you. I won't be able to finish this guy. Hope you've enjoyed, watching me paint some Marines up and, just hanging out, chilling with music as well. Yeah, thanks for, tuning in. It's been good to see us. Probably won't be streaming next weekend, but the weekend after that, definitely count on it, whether it's Tarkov or whether it's a painting or a hobby stream as well. But yeah, but for now, chat, thanks for watching. It's been great having yous, and I will catch you guys